He goes by many names. The 13th son, the Leeds devil, the devil of the pines. No matter his true name, there's no denying the fact that this creature has struck fear into the hearts of many a piney and tourist alike. Whatever you do, don't go into the Pine Barrens of New Jersey alone. That's right. This episode is all about the Jersey Devil. Boy, howdy, do I have something exciting to share with y'all today. I'm starting up a new series called DIY or Die, where I not only share cool stories on hauntings and horror, murder and mysteries, but I do some crafts or DIYs related to every story. I thought this sounded fun, maybe a little spooky, maybe a little terrifying. I feel like I have a lot of like cool ideas floating around in my brain. They may be cool ideas, but I can't guarantee they're gonna be any good on paper or whatever medium it is I choose to use, but you guys can be the judge of that. You never know, it could come out really cool and maybe you'll wanna make it for yourself. So to kick off this series, I figured why not start with one of the most talked about cryptids in the Northeast? I also figured, why don't we immortalize him by making him out of clay and utilizing his visage as a display piece in our home? Make sure you check out the description box below. That's where I'm gonna have a link to the blog post that gives you all of the details for the DIY, as well as all of the links to everything that I used to make the project. So without further ado, let's get into it. The Pine Barrens. You may have heard of these woods before. Also known as the Pine Lands, this massive forest crosses over more than 7 counties of New Jersey. There are only 2 other ecosystems like this left, the Long Island Central Pine Barrens and the Massachusetts Coastal Pine Barrens. The soil here is sandy, which has made it difficult for settlers to produce crops in the area. So even though there was a boom of early settlers, most of them left in search of more viable land than the sugar sand that the Barrens were able to provide. The folks left behind were heretofore called the Pineys. What the Pine Barrens are good at growing are unique forms of plants, including but not limited to orchids and carnivorous plants. The area is also known to grow the rare pygmy pitch pine, say that 5 times fast, that relies on the frequent fires of the Pine Barrens in order to reproduce. Thankfully, the Pine Barrens have been left mostly undisturbed. But for much of this area being left untouched, locals are left to wonder what lingers inside. It's been told that something doesn't feel right when you step into those woods. Dread and despair overcome some who wander, while most refuse to wander at all. Tales have been told for over 300 years about the hauntings of the Pine Barrens. The Mentatec and the Lenape tribes believe that wood dwarves occupied the land and were very territorial. Others have claimed to see and hear the Big Red Eye, a creature described much like Bigfoot, except he had large red eyes and was a total creeper who would like stare in your windows, or a monkey man who a whole bunch of children claimed to see in Hoboken back in the early and mid 80s. Jersey and the Pine Barren area are also home to the Lizard Man of Great Meadows, the Cape May sea serpent, and various larger-than-life cat species that locals have claimed to see between the trees. Let's start with the Lenape tribe. Long ago, this tribe dubbed the Pine Barrens Papawasan, which means place of the dragon. This is because the Lenape claimed to see a strange deer-like creature with dragon wings in the forest. This was a long-standing tale that the tribe told, advising all those who wandered past the tree line to be cautious. Fast forward to the 17th century. Settlers moved into the area. The Lenape warned these people of Papawasan and the creature that lives within. They tell their stories to newcomers who ultimately think that the indigenous people of these lands told too many tall tales and spoke of too many superstitions. However, by the 18th century, people began leaving in drones. Pioneers started murmuring something about a demon in the woods, something that they come to know as the Leeds Devil. This creature sounds terrifying. Although some of the pictures from the 1900s may make you think otherwise. However, the accounts in the Leeds Devil describe it as a bipedal horse-like creature with wings like a bat or a dragon, large dark round eyes, short clawed front feet, long thin legs, and a serpent-like forked tail. There are small variations to this description. Does it have hooves or talons, red eyes or black? But the majority of the features have been agreed upon throughout the region for generations. The other thing that's widely agreed upon? The blood-curdling scream of the Jersey Devil. It's said to have haunted anybody who's heard its call. So why was the Jersey Devil originally called the Leeds Devil? Let's start there. Let's talk origin stories. The year was 1735. Miss Shroud of Leeds Point found herself pregnant with her 13th child. The Pine Barrens are a harsh and unforgiving place, and the Leeds family didn't have the means to provide for yet another child. Secretly, Miss Leeds wished for it to be the devil's son, a wish that she hoped would take the child away so that she could focus on the family that she already had. It is said that the baby was malformed and misshapen when she gave birth, so she hid him away where the community couldn't discover it. And then one night, a dark and stormy night, her son's arms grew into wings and he hissed and flew away up the chimney. Another version of the story is similar, except instead of a Mrs. Shroud, it's a Mrs. Leeds from Burlington. Mrs. Leeds was known to dabble in witchcraft despite her Quaker beliefs, which were also frowned on by the Puritans, and they were often prosecuted, but that's a whole other story for a whole other time. She was so outspoken about her witchcraft beliefs that she started talking about them to the midwives. It's said that she growled, "Let this one be the devil," before giving birth to her handsome baby boy. The midwives admired the child for a short period of time before handing him over to Mrs. Leeds. However, once the boy reached his mother's arms, his body elongated and stretched to the size of a man. His skin crumpled and cracked. His feet turned hooven. As screams erupted from the Leeds home, the child continued to change, his face distorting into that of a horse, and large bat-like wings sliced out from underneath his shoulder blades. His bones crunched and moaned as he swiped at the midwives until finally he screamed that blood-curdling Jersey Devil scream and flew up the chimney, never to be seen again. Now, there is a second part of this story that includes a group of clergymen that went to hunt the Jersey Devil that very night he was born. It's said that they searched the Pine Barrens all night for him, but when the next day came, they showed up empty-handed. Our third and final origin story is probably the most likely culprit here. This story brings us to a Mr. Daniel Leeds. Now, Mr. Leeds was also a Quaker. However, he was not very popular with his community. Back in 1687, Daniel published New Jersey's very first almanac, called the Leeds Almanac, or the American Almanac, depending on which accounts you look at. The Quakers were not fans of this, as Leeds' publication was filled with astrology and other celestial symbolism. They felt that the papers were too pagan and put out an order to destroy his works. Daniel was furious, so he withdrew from the community and began posting anti-Quaker pamphlets and his almanacs again, all on his own. This time, he added even more esoteric writings as he began to obsess over demonology, cosmology, and other mysticologies. The Quakers accused Daniel of working with the devil and shunned him in the community. Time passes, Daniel retires and turns his business over to his son Titan. With a renewed sense of vigor, Titan continues the printing of the family almanac, this time adding their family crest to the published documents, which just so happens to resemble a dragon-like creature. Titan Leeds was a man of many words, words that ultimately ended up getting him into a little feud with another young publisher in the area. You might know him. His name's Benjamin Franklin. Ben didn't take kindly to Titan and his almanac, so he created his own, called Poor Richard's Almanac, in 1733. In it, he takes a few jabs at Leeds, going so far as to predict Titan's death down to the minute, the day, and the hour. Now, he used astrology as his basis, which I find very interesting. This pissed Titan off, of course, but not as much as being dubbed the monster in Leeds. As the war of words went on, rumors began to spread about a devil in Leeds Point, an ugly, dragon-like spawn of Satan that was once a normal child, a devil that now haunts the depths of the Pine Barrens. Listen, I am a sucker for a good devil-in-the-woods story, and I really wish I could just say that there's a wicked witch out there that gave birth to a devil that now lives in the Pine Barrens of New Jersey. But it's hard for me not to lean towards good old Ben making rumors about the Leeds family because he didn't like them. There's a ton of other speculation around this story, too. Titan's father was married to a lady named Deborah Smith, his first wife, who died in childbirth. It's also said that Daniel signed a census that stated he had 12 kids. There are no real records to confirm these stories. However, there is one thing that we do have a record of that kind of turns this story on its head, and that's the amount of sightings of the Jersey Devil. There have been massive amounts of people who have claimed to see this thing, and we will talk about that more in the next episode of DIY or Die. Thank you. it's outro time. If you had a good time hanging out with me today, make sure that you subscribe. There will hopefully be a new upload every week with equally as enticing content as you saw today. If you have any ideas on any creatures, haunts, or horrors that you would like to see, make sure you leave them down in the comments below. Thanks for doing spooky stuff with me. I had a blast. I'll see you next time. Bye. No fingers. No fingers. We ain't doing that. We ain't putting them up. Sing me the song of your people, Chihuahua. Get through it. Okay.